In this video, we're computing the integral of e to the negative x times sine x on the interval 0 to infinity. Now you may recognize the form of this integral as requiring multiple applications of integration by parts, and then a trick emerges that I normally call the looping trick, where we get a copy of the original integral after a couple iterations of integration by parts. Now as we're working through this, we're applying these limits of integration 0 to infinity, so this is an improper integral. But that infinity isn't really going to cause any significant complications, as we'll see in a minute. So we begin this integral with our integration by parts substitutions. We're going to let u equal e to the negative x, and that means du is the derivative of that. That's negative e to the negative x times dx. Now dv is going to be the rest of this integral, and that's sine x dx, which means v itself is the antiderivative of that, or negative cosine x. Now we sub into the integration by parts formula, and this means our integral can be rewritten as u times v, so we have negative e to the negative x cosine x, and this is a definite integral, so we need to evaluate this from 0 to infinity, minus the integral of v du. Now v times du, both of those have minus signs in front, and those are going to cancel out, but we still have the minus sign in front of the whole integral. So we end up with the integral of e to the negative x cosine x dx on 0 to infinity. So at first glance, you might say, well, we didn't really make any progress here because we got left with an integral that's just as complicated as what we started with. But this is a natural part of the integration by parts looping trick, and we just iterate the process one more time. Now, before we do that, I want to go ahead and evaluate this first term across the limits of integration. And when I sub in the upper limit of infinity, that gives me e to the negative infinity. Another way to say that is 1 over e to the infinity. So we're taking 1 divided by this infinite value. That unambiguously gives us 0 for that term. And at the same time, the cosine function, when x becomes very large, is always finite. It simply oscillates between negative 1 and 1. So we have 0 times a finite number, which gives us 0. Then we subtract what we get from subbing in the lower limit, and e to the 0 is 1, and cosine of 0 is 1. So we're subtracting negative 1. In other words, we get a 1 out there. So now we get into our second iteration of integration by parts. And one key point here is that we have to let u be the same piece of this integral. So in other words, the exponential piece. So I'm going to let u be e to the negative x. And again, du is negative e to the negative x dx. And we're going to let dv be the rest of this integral. That's cosine x dx, which means v is sine x. So now we make our integration by parts substitutions. And remember, there's a 1 hanging out in front of this thing now. So we have 1 minus the result of this integral. And that's u times v, so e to the negative x sine x. Again, it's a definite integral, so we have to evaluate that from 0 to infinity. And then minus the integral from 0 to infinity of v du. Now notice this time, when we multiply v and du, we get a minus sign out of that. So we get e to the negative x sine x dx, but with a minus sign inside that integrand. Well, I'd rather pull that factor of negative 1 out in front and just cancel the minus sign in front of the integral. So before we clean things up, let's go ahead and evaluate this leading term across the limits of integration. When I sub in infinity, I have the same phenomenon with e to the negative x. Letting x get really large creates a 1 over infinity limit, which is 0. And because the sine function is bounded between negative 1 and 1, I have 0 times a finite number, which is 0. This time, when I sub in 0 for the lower limit, I also get 0, because e to the 0 is 1, but the sine of 0 is 0. So both of those are gone, and we're going to distribute the minus sign into those parentheses, and this gives me 1 minus the integral from 0 to infinity of e to the negative x sine x dx. And this is the moment where the looping trick pays off. What we just discovered on the right-hand side here is the negative of the original integral. Now this whole time, we've just been making modifications of our original integral, which is still over there on the left side of the equation. So all I have to do is add this integral to both sides of the equation. And that gives me twice the original integral. So twice the integral from 0 to infinity, e to the negative x sine x dx is equal to 1. This allows us to quickly isolate our original integral and find its value. So I have the integral from 0 to infinity, e to the negative x sine x dx is equal to 1/2. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.